We're out here at the brand new fire station number 2, and we're really excited. Today we're going live, we're going operational, we're moving into the station. I forgot something, I'll be right back. Oh yeah, that is what I've been looking for. We are in Appleton, Wisconsin this morning at the Pierce Manufacturing Plant.
Oh, we're here to look at our new truck too, new fire truck.
It's a replacement for a approximately 12-year-old apparatus that we have.
So we're here to do the final inspection, make sure everything's right, and things that aren't right, get them fixed and get it back home.
We started the process by contacting Pierce and let him know what type of vehicle we wanted to purchase, and we actually built it from the ground up. Each one of these fire apparatus is truly a custom vehicle.
We don't build a cookie cutter fire truck.
Like snowflakes, none of these fire trucks are alike.
It would be very similar to building your own home. You have to decide colors, the seats, tank size, what systems you want on the truck, how you want the equipment to operate.
There's over 100,000 different variations you can do to one of these.
I had no idea what went into putting one of these trucks together from start to finish.
It's a very long process, a very detailed process.
The paperwork, the planning, the engineering.
How do you manage that? How do you develop that? How do you pull all that information together? And that kind of starts to put into scope what the effort is.
It takes about 18 months, I guess, from start to finish.
It basically comes from a sheet of steel from the factory. They lay it on a laser cutter and they start cutting the pieces. This thing is produced one piece at a time.
They actually take raw materials and they form it, bend it, weld it, build the actual cabs and bodies, pump houses.
Engineering literally has to sit down and look at each and every component that's put on the truck to make sure it fits and works as a completed vehicle.
And we need to actually come up and inspect the truck to make sure that everything works as intended and designed. It's a very expensive piece of equipment. We need to make sure we're getting our money's worth.
We literally touch every square inch of this truck.
Hey, will you check and see if that dome light works? That red one right above your head. Thank you.
We're checking this truck from head to toe, every single nut and bolt.
Go through each compartment, all the mechanical aspects, get under the truck, on top of the truck.
We got on the floor with our flashlights and safety glasses and looked all up underneath the inside of the truck.
And then we test everything to make sure that it functions properly.
Raised the ladder and we verified it works. And here in a little while, we're gonna go flow some water. It'll be really neat to see.
Here comes your water.
If we find any issues, they're documented in a computer that creates a list of issues that have to be addressed.
Pierce will take that final checklist and we'll make sure everything's corrected, and then we'll deliver it to the Allen Fire Department.
And once it's delivered to us, then we'll inspect it one more time based on our previous list.
Outline lights with the rubber arms, I saw those.
We want to make sure it's compliant with their specs. We also want to make sure that they get a good life out of the vehicle.
There's one good reason we go through the fine-tooth comb is the citizens have entrusted us with a great deal of money. And so we want to make sure that no mistakes were made along the way.
I think it's tight.
It just torques.
Yeah, it just torques. If you're a citizen of Allen and you're looking at this new truck, it is a significant improvement over the truck that it is replacing.
It's very exciting to be involved with such a dynamic product.
We're really excited about this truck.
We're gonna have more storage space. So now we can add more tools to help us do our job.
They need a lot of compartment space because they do multiple functions, not just firefighting. We do EMS, we do rescue work, hazmat, so they take on a lot of roles.
New technology enhancements have come around since the last time we did a truck. It has a lighter weight ladder, which allows us to get more distance with less weight.
The ladder is now longer, so we'll be able to rescue more.
With the setbacks of the house as being a little further, this 105-foot ladder will actually reach more of those.
rear steering is amazing. It handles corners so much better.
It's where the rear wheels steer in conjunction with the front wheels.
The addition of that T3 steering will help us get down some of these really tight streets.
If you hit a corner or hit a curb, you had to buy ice cream. It's going to be harder to hit corners and curbs in this thing. There'll probably be a much bigger shortage of ice cream around the stations now.
Now they get the community involved, so they have pride in it as well. They know they've got a good investment for their money.
This vehicle will allow us to more efficiently and more effectively respond to the types of calls that we're seeing right now in the district.
The city of Allen is now better for having it.
It'll definitely help us in giving the citizens a better response and being able to serve them a lot better.
I love it. It's great. We're really excited to get it out on the road, get it around town.
This is wonderful. It's the best truck we have to date.
It's not just a truck. Put it in terms of us. If we were to have a fire truck come and save one of our family members, we'd want it to be one of our trucks because we know what we put into it.
Yeah, that looks really good right there. We're ready to roll. For more information on the Allen Fire Department, please visit allenfire.org.